Machining of complex parts has never been simpler than it is today with TopSolid'Cam 7. Here, we're starting this demonstration by showing you the simulation of the machining for this part. In a little bit, we'll show you step by step how easy it is to create all of this toolpath, and more importantly, how quickly you can create all of this toolpath. The reason we have machine simulation inside of TopSolid 7 is so that while you're machining complex parts on multiple positions, you can check for collisions against your workpiece, your holders, and your fixtures. Knowing that you are collision free makes you feel much more safe about pressing cycle start out on the machine inside of the real world. Here, hopefully you get a good feeling of how valuable machine simulation can be. Now, why don't we show you how we test that we've captured the kinematic of your machine? For example, here, you see me dragging a little scroll bar back and forth. And this is used to test each independent axis that we're driving within TopSolid'Cam 7. This allows us to validate the strokes for each of these axes. One of the things we check for during programming is that we don't over travel any of these axes as well. And the only way we can tell you that is if we have them defined correctly here in our machine definition. So maybe now we'll take a closer look at what it takes to programming a part such as this, and the steps it takes to get the toolpath on the screen. Let's have a look, shall we? Here we're going to start by choosing our first tool. Here you can see some dynamic previews of the tools we already have loaded on this machine. Next, we're going to select the face that we want to machine. And like that, we're just going to validate. And we have toolpath. Now we're going to hold Control and drag and drop a copy of that toolpath onto that inclined plane. And TopSolid 7 automatically adapts. Now we're going to make another copy of this toolpath to the same top face, but this time we're going to change the cutter. All we want to do is maybe have a smaller diameter cutting tool now. And we'll validate. And like that, you can see TopSolid'Cam 7 is rest machining. Now we're going to drag that rest machining into that pocket. And we'll drag that up onto that face there. And again, we're doing all of this programming with simple drag and drop ease. We're just making copies of our existing strategies. And if you look in the Operations Manager, TopSolid'Cam is making the decision for the type of machining we're going to use. It's creating open pocketings, facings, and pocketings based on the topology of the geometry we drop that toolpath on. Next, maybe we want to cut with the side of the cutter. So again, we're going to go ahead and select the type of tool that we want to use, and then we'll select the piece of geometry that we want to assign it to. In this case, we're going to machine that face there. TopSolid'Cam 7 is automatically checking against the machine to make sure that we can reach that angular solution. And even when we're cutting with the side of the cutter, we can dynamically drag and drop copies to other faces around the model. Now watch what happens when we drag and drop a copy to this face back there. Watch the lead out position. You'll notice that it automatically avoids the wall in the back. How smart is this toolpath? Now we're just going to turn on that toolpath so we can drag and drop a copy of that onto the top of that face there. And like that, in just a few short minutes, we've completely programmed the part that we simulated for you at the beginning of this demonstration.